Hey everyone, welcome back to Getting Epic. I just got out of some surgery. Kind of been a little rough the past couple days. I just had a cardiac ablation. If you want to learn about that or hear what's going on, stay for the rest of this episode. Alright, well, let's get this one started. So yesterday, I went to cardiac rehab and I jumped on the bicycle. And I was on the bicycle for no longer than 1 minute. And I was having these PVCs, but they were back to back. And I had about 6 to 8 in a row and I started feeling very dizzy. So the nurses thought it'd be right for me to go down to the emergency room to get checked out. I went down. They ran a bunch of tests. They changed my medication. And then they released me. Yeah. How'd I end up in the hospital bed? So when I was walking out of the hospital, I got this major attack again. So I had to sit down. A nurse saw me, asked if I was okay, took my blood pressure. Something didn't look right. So they pulled me back and put me back in the bed. But an hour or two later, I was being rushed over to Tufts Medical Center. That's where I lay right now. Well, rewind. After one night, I woke up and I met with an electrical physiologist. And he kind of told me my options. We can try to control these issues with medication, or we can go head forward into an ablation surgery, or a procedure, he calls it. That's not surgery. So I was like, yeah, I'm young, I'm 35. There's no need for me to take pills all my life. Let's try and nab this. There was some serious health risks involved. Like, they could scar one of my wrong lymphoids. That fires electricity through my heart, which then would have made me dependent, kind of like Iron Man. I would have a pacemaker, and without the pacemaker, I couldn't live. So that was kind of scary. And the second big risk was a stroke, because they're in my major arteries, and they could create a blockage somehow. So those are my two big risk factors. Luckily, none of those, you know, came about. The surgery, around 6 or 7 hours long, I feel like. 2 hours of it was just prepping. I mean, you were just laying there. I was awake the entire time, so it felt like forever. But once everything was all set, you're strapped to a bed, and they insert two holes right in your groin. So I have a nice bikini wax right now. It's the first time I can say that and be proud of it, right? Woo, yeah. So then they went up into my heart, to my major arteries, and they mapped my heart. And then once they created a 3D version of my heart, they gave me this stuff that was kind of like espresso. We always joked in the room that it was espresso. Giving you more espresso. They really wanted to kind of get my heart going and moving really, really fast. So that way they can kind of see where the blockages are. So they went in, they scarred those. It started hurting a ton. So they had to sedate me a little bit. Finally, right? But the problem with the sedation is it brings down the arrhythmias. So it got to a point where the doctors couldn't see anything additional. So they had to end the surgery. I got rolled back to my room where I sit right now, or I lay right now. Yay, let's take a look. Just laying in bed. I can't move for 4 hours. the surgeon, doctor, came in, spoke to me. I have to lay here for 4 hours. I can't move because, you know, there are major arteries and that could burst open and I could bleed out. Short answer. But a few minutes ago, my doctor came in, the one who performed the surgery, and he told me that, you know, they got 80% of it. So there's still a bunch more there. So it looks like I will be spending my Labor Day weekend laying in the hospital. In the hospital, getting on some new medication that they have to monitor me on. And if that does not work, then I might have another ablation surgery. I don't know. I will try to create a new post every day and try to keep up with it this time. Alright, if you haven't already, please consider liking and subscribing to my channel. I hope you're not in the hospital. I hope you're enjoying a nice barbecue or doing something a little bit more exciting. I miss my family. I miss my wife. I really miss my son. I just want to be at home with them right now, relaxing and doing what we want to do and not, you know, laying in a hospital bed and everything else. But I will have to say, one bonus, because I have sleep apnea, it releases particles. I did score my own room. So, yeah, it's pretty sweet. But I have all these IVs, so it's really hard for me to sleep and stuff. And then I got cords everywhere. Looking up at the clock, I have 2.5 hours left until I can get up and out of bed. And then I plan to go for a nice little walk to check out the new ticker. Alright, well, look out for another video tomorrow. Alright, have a nice day, guys. Bye.